This is the Beyond the Basics with Microsoft PowerPoint 2016 series by Trillium Creative Solutions. In this video, we'll explore merging shapes. If you just want to know where to find it on the ribbon and what the different options do, here you go. PowerPoint provides a variety of shapes. And now we have icons too. Many of the shapes are smart shapes that can be customized using these yellow adjustment handles. You can also edit any kind of shape using edit points, and I'll touch on that later. But sometimes we need a shape that's not already available, like a wrench, a purse, a circle with an arrow to indicate a clockwise motion, or some other shape to fit your context. The wrench is a bit complicated, so we'll look at it later. But let's see how easy it is to make these shapes into more unified versions using the union merge. I made copies so you can see the before and after. Now just select the two shapes. I used a half circle and cylinder here. Then apply the union merge. And we'll do that again for the rest. We can just select them and repeat the merge using Ctrl Y or F4. So here they are, the union merged shapes. The intersect merge creates a single shape from all selected shapes and only keeps the area where all selected shapes overlap. I'll demonstrate with these copies. When you're going through the merge shapes options, it gives you a live preview of each option so that you can see what it will do before deciding which one to use. You can also use intersect to fill a shape with a background image. You could just set the shape to have the image as the background fill. So I'll show that first. I'll copy this orange image so it's on the clipboard. Then use it for the background. But this will warp the image to fill the smaller shape area. Using intersect instead will fill the triangle with just the area of the image that it overlaps. That lets you control what part of the image becomes the background by placing the triangle over that area of the image. It's also important to select them in the right order. We need to select the image first and then the triangle. Since resting on intersect gives you a preview, if you're not happy with what you see, don't apply it yet. Adjust the triangle over the image. Preview again until you've got what you want. Then apply the intersect. Here's another example. For the first circle, we used fill. And for the second, we use the intersect merge, so we could control how much of the image is in the circle. Earlier, when I set the background for the triangle, I selected the image first, then the shape, before intersecting. The selection order was very important. When the shapes have different formatting, PowerPoint uses the format of the shape you select first. This goes for all merge types. In the first example here, I selected the red circle first. So it used that format. In the second example, I selected the blue circle first. And when you click and drag to select the objects, it uses their stacking order, so the shape in the back is first and controls the format. The next merge is subtract. The subtract merge cuts away or removes any overlapping areas. Larger versions of this square and circle shown here were used to create this left border feature. The overlapping area is removed, and you end up with a single shape as the result. Again, the selection order is important. It will remove all overlapping areas from the shape you selected first. Now back to that wrench. Sometimes you'll need to merge in stages to achieve what you want. First, we union merge the circle and oval. Then subtract the smaller circle and pentagon. The selection order for subtract controls which shape is being subtracted from which. So in the subtract phase, you should select the blue shape first. And you can subtract both red shapes at the same time. Here's another example using union and subtract to create a single camera shape and a skeleton key. The fragment merge breaks up all selected shapes based on where they intersect. I've colored each new fragment a different color so you can see how many were created. The combine merge creates a single shape from the selected shapes and removes any overlapping areas. You can be really creative with this merge type. Again, the format of the first shape selected is used for the result. So if it has an outline, the outline is applied to all the shapes before the merge, but you can change it or remove it afterward. Here's a cool example of using the combine merge. The text and shape become one shape. So changing the shape color changes the text also. I'll show you how I made it. For the text, you can use a text box or word art like I used here. I added a rectangle, and now I'll customize it. Now I'll move the text so that one letter will get the split color from the shape. Then just select them both and apply the combine merge. Here's some additional inspiration. Thanks for watching, and look for more of our Beyond the Basics videos. If you found this video helpful, let us know in the comments below, and also let us know if there are more topics you'd like us to cover.